California driving, had to get out. Distance got me wondering where you are right now. One-way conversations got me worn down. Pouring out my heart, wish you would speak a sound. Get you out of my head, and I don't wanna ever forget. You give me what the world can never give. I can't live without you. I can't live without you. I can't live without you. Ceiling after midnight, overthinking everything in my whole life. All of these regrets are clouding my mind. Lord, I need the strength to try it one more time. 'Cause now I know what I'm after. Now I know what I'm doing, doing. Now I know what I'm after. Now I know that I'm. Without your love, there's no point in even waking up. No, 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 no. Without your love, nothing's ever gonna be enough. No, 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 no. I can't get you out of my head. And I don't wanna ever forget. You give me what the world can never give. I can't.
Enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. must be a God. I believe it's true, 'cause I can see His love when I look at you. And He must have a plan for this crazy life, 'cause He brought you here.
Who gives us the hand of Teagan in marriage today? You're not sure, are you?
Are you sure about this?
You're sure?
Her mother and I.
Fantastic. Blake, would the two of you come and stand here for just a moment? Now, before we get started, I'd like to say thank you for all of you coming to this marriage ceremony between Blake Price and Teagan Joe. What a wonderful couple. Had a chance to watch you grow. Let's pray. God, You have amazed us. From the very beginning, You created this earth, and You created man and woman to fill it. And God, You have blessed us with families, You've blessed us with opportunities, and You've blessed us with Blake and Teagan. God, what an amazing thing. And we're so richly blessed to be here today to watch them become one with each other and one with You, God. So, Father, we thank You for letting us be here, and thank You for all these people joining with us as witnesses to this marriage. Bless us, Father, through Jesus we pray. Amen. Would you be seated, please? Blake and Teagan, it's a special day for me. I think it was several months ago you asked me if I'd be willing to work with you on this wedding ceremony, right? And I'm just honored. And you know the thing that honors me the most? As I've watched you over the last few years grow together. I've watched you grow. And what I've seen in you is the things that we all, this audience, if you look out and see them for a second, this audience cherishes the most. You guys are filled with joy and love, pride. You're filled with the wonderful things we all seek and the security that can be found in each other. And when we watched you grow, you brought us great joy. And so it's an honor to be here to share that joy with you today as you marry. So Blake and Teagan, I want to say to you that there's something very special. Today you're choosing to enter into a, sorry about that. You know, I've got a tear of my own. I'm not supposed to shed tears, but I do. Blake, you'll make him cry too, Teagan. Believe me, you will. I wasn't going to do anything funny during this deal, was I? Anyway. What I would say to you is you have brought us such great joy. Blake, as you grew, watching you grow, Teagan, your parents, you brought them tremendous joy. And now you have a chance, an opportunity. This new day that you're starting is a day in which you're going to join together and be one. And you two, coming together as one, will have the same kind of things that you have so richly shared with us. And that's in each other. You're going to find the joy and the peace and the security. You're going to go through some really tough times. Believe me, I haven't seen a married couple yet who doesn't go through some tough times. And you're going to go through some great times. And when you do, you're not supposed to cry either, Blake, I tell you. You know, but when you go through those really good times, you're going to be at a high between the two of you that you've never been on before. And so I want to encourage you to remember the journey you have taken us on. And now start a journey of your own, because what you're entering into is a journey. It's a journey that started a long time ago. You know, back in Genesis, God created. Well, let me just point out something to you. I'd like for you to just look, if you'll look beyond me and look out here at the beautiful trees and maybe up at the sky. You know, a lot of people try to find God in those things, don't they? And God did create them. There's no question about that. But you know what God created? The greatest thing He created is He created you and I and all these people in this audience. And if you look at this audience now, you're going to see the footprints of God in the lives of these people. You want to look out and just take a look? Look at your mom and dad. You know, what you're going to see in them is the footprints of God. And what God is doing is He's promised to put His footprint with you. So when you marry, the two of you are going to become one. You know, in Genesis, when God was speaking in Genesis chapter 2, and by the way, I outlined this. You can read this all later, Blake. But in Genesis chapter 2, he talks about he created man and woman. And when he put Adam out in the garden and created all these animals, Adam watched the animals march by, and God was going to say, what are you going to name them? And as they marched by, I guess God noticed something that was a little unique that he talks about in Genesis 2. Adam just didn't seem to have the right creation that was suitable for him. So we all know the story. He caused Adam to go into a deep sleep, right? We know that story. And in his sleep, he took a rib and he created woman. Now, there's a difference here. The difference is in all the other creation, God created all these creatures that fill this earth out of dirt. But at this time, he creates woman, the helper of man. And I don't mean helper in the sense of slave, Blake. I want to point that out to you. Teagan, you can remind him of that. He created woman to be his partner for all of life. And he made it very special because he knew that when he created you and I, he created mankind that needs someone else to be part of it. So in Ecclesiastes, when the writer of Psalms, Ecclesiastes chapter 5, when he writes and he says, you know, two are better than one. You know, with two people, it's harder to overcome. If one falls down, the other can pick them up. That's what you're doing, is the two of you are going to pick each other up when it's difficult. But then it goes on to say, three are better than two. Because when you have God on your side, you're stronger than anyone can possibly overcome. So I want you to think about that a little bit. Because God's intention was to create a helper for you, Blake, a mate for you, Teagan. But his intention was also for you to have him as your third partner in your marriage. Now, God is here. We said that God, some people look for it in the trees and all that. I like to think that I see God in the witnesses that are here. And I'm seeing God in you. God won't stay away. The only choice you have is whether you recognize him or reject him. Does that make sense? So as you go forward, I want you to remember that three are stronger than two. It's really important for you to do that because God's going to be right there. And when you get a little angry with Blake, Teagan, and when you get frustrated with Teagan, Blake, I want you to remember God is right there in the room with you. And understand, he's hearing it all, right? And he does. He does. He hears it all. You guys are a very special couple, and I want to spend just another couple of minutes. I want to take you on a journey. I'm going to do this in my own terms, if you don't mind. This is a biblical passage found in the New Testament, but I'm going to try to put it in my own words just for two of you. See, God knows that when you start out on this journey and two become one, that it's not going to be easy all the time. And so he gives you a couple of guidelines in the New Testament. The Apostle Paul wrote these. And he gives you a couple of guidelines in here that I think are really helpful. You're going to wake up one day in the next week, Teagan. And you're going to look over at Blake and you're going to say, what did I do? You know, as beautiful as Sherry is to me, I know she woke up sometime and she looked and she says, oh no, did I choose this? Now, I don't mean that you'll want to go back on that. Not at all. But what I do mean is that there's going to be times that you're going to say, did I make the right decision? But over all those difficult times, there's one thing that holds true that the writer of Ephesians said. He said, Teagan, always put Blake first. Because when you get in those tough times and you always put Blake first, above yourself, despite all the wants and needs you have, if you can put Blake first, your marriage will truly be one. You'll be happier, you'll be delighted, and you can have Blake just exactly where he needs to be, and that's working with you one-on-one, just together as one. But Blake, he also didn't leave you out of the equation. He said, what I want you to do is I want you to respect your wife. I want you to honor your wife. And your need on this thing is even greater when Paul talked. Your need is to be willing to lay down your life for Teagan. She is not only first, but she becomes everything to you. And it's wonderful. It's wonderful because it will draw you together in a bond that when God is there, no one will ever break. Now, I've listened to your vows, and I've read through those vows a couple of times, and I'm just really impressed. I'm really impressed with what you've written. I'm impressed with the wisdom that's there and the maturity that's there. So what I'd like for you to do is I'd like for everybody else to listen to your vows. Do you have those with you? Or do you? Okay. So Teagan, would you recite your vows to Blake, please? Let me get a microphone. Okay.
Blake, I can't believe how God has far surpassed my wildest dreams and prayers with the man that you are. And today, in front of all of our family, friends, and most importantly, God, I choose you. I choose you to be my husband and my best friend forever. And every single day, no matter what the future holds, no matter the joys or the heartaches, I will never stop choosing you. I promise to pray for you and pray with you daily and always point you to Jesus the best that I can. I promise to laugh at your jokes, no matter how bad they are. I promise to stand beside you and as you chase after your dreams and follow you wherever God leads us. I promise to always put our marriage, this gift from God, before myself. I promise to pursue you and keep pursuing you for the rest of our lives. I promise to encourage your hobbies, creativity, dreams, and talents. I promise to stay faithful to you, to dream with you, to celebrate with you, and to be your shoulder to cry on. I can't promise to love you perfectly, but I will love you messily, overwhelmingly, and persistently. I promise to fight for your heart like Jesus has fought for mine, and I promise to support you as the leader of our family. I could not be more blessed to be able to spend the rest of my life with you. I love you.
Blake, how about your vows for Teagan?
See if I can compose myself. Teagan, I promise before God and our friends and family here today to be loving and faithful to you and to you only. I will stand by you in happiness and success, as well as in disappointment and sorrow. I promise to respect your decisions and to never put my dreams ahead of yours. I will be honest with you, open with you, and show you continuous mercy. And I will always forgive you as Christ forgives us. I promise to be a spiritual leader for you and our family, and to always remind you of God's endless love for you. I'll continuously pray for you and with you. I know marriage won't be easy, but I promise to choose to love you each and every day. I will push you, support you, and above all else, love you for the rest of our lives.
Folks, I don't know what you just heard them say to each other, but what I heard is I choose you. Isn't that wonderful? Both of them said that. I will pursue you. I will love you all of my days. I'm never going to leave you. Now, you might frustrate me just a little bit, but I'm never going to leave you. Isn't that wonderful? What wonderful words. And that's something we all want, is that everyone in this whole audience wants that security and that love and that pursuit that you talk about. So what a wonderful way to start a marriage. But this couple, if I can speak to all of you, this couple would like to do something a little different. What they'd like to do is they'd like to start out with that third partner we talked about a while ago, and that's God. And to do that, they've chosen to celebrate communion together, and they want you to celebrate with them. Each one of you should have received a little communion cup like this. Okay? I'll ask you to tear the top of the cup off and expose just the bread portion of that, if you can do that, the wafer that's in the top. And if you'll hold it for just a minute, then I'm going to ask Blake and Teagan to go up behind me. What they're going to do is they're going to share communion together, just the two of them. Now, they'll be praying for each other during this communion time. They'll be praying for each other during this communion time. I'll offer a prayer for all of us in just a moment, and then Blake and Teagan will start sharing their communion. As you observe them start to share the bread, then will you please have your bread? So let's pray. God, your blessings, again, are so rich. We have heard Teagan say to Blake that she wants to marry him, that she chooses him, and that she will pursue him, that she'll love him, and that it will be enduring. And Father, we've heard Blake say to Teagan the same things, that he will choose her and has chosen her, that he will pursue her and that he will never stop loving her. And so, God, we know you are the same way with us, and you are the same way with Blake and Teagan right now. So this bread represents the body of Jesus Christ, but it also represents the physical lives of Blake and Teagan at this time. So we ask that you bless them and bless us as we partake of it, as we share this communion that Blake and Teagan are observing. Through Jesus we ask. Amen.
The moon and stars, they met. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, his blood poured out for us, the weight of every curse upon him. One final breath he gave as heaven looked away. The Son of God was laid in darkness. A battle in the grave, the war on death was waged, the power of hell forever broke.
Blake is going to pray for Teagan at this time. He's going to be praying over the mine, and he's going to be praying that God will continue to be part of their lives. You know, a New Testament teaching, Blake Teagan, blood is what gives life. And what you're doing right now is praying that God gives you life in this cup that you're about to take. So would you join me in prayer for all of us, please? God, we pray that you will bless Teagan and Blake with the fullness of life. A life that comes from knowing you, a life that comes from the love that they have for each other, a life that can never be taken away. And so, Father, we pray that you will bless them and that you'll bless us just as you did with Jesus Christ when he died and rose again. Through Jesus we pray. Amen. I don't know how you feel right now in the audience, but it's hard not to be moved by what you've just done. The two of you praying together over each other, the two of you inviting God to be part of that is just amazing to me. Thank you for letting me be part of that. You know, I think it's time for you guys to get married, don't you? Think it's about that time? So we were going to have a ring ceremony, and normally we like to make sure the bride is taken care of first. So, Blake, do you have a token of your relationship for her? Do you have a ring? I understand you do for her.
I do.
Okay. So would you place that ring on Teagan's ring finger? Okay, and repeat after me, Blake. I, Blake.
Take you, Teagan.
To be my wife. Your love is my anchor. Your trust is my strength. I will give you all my love. From now till eternity ends. You make my life complete. Fantastic. What a wonderful commitment you've just made. Teagan, do you have a ring for Blake?
I do.
You do? I didn't mean to sound surprised. You told me you did. So if you'll place the ring on Blake's ring finger, please. Repeat after me. I, Teagan. Take you, Blake. To be my husband. Your love is my anchor. Your trust is my strength. I will give you all my love. From now until eternity ends. You make my life complete. Thank you. If you guys would face the audience, I have to tell you that's a wonderful thing. I think it's time to pronounce them husband and wife. So this is Mr. and Mrs. Blake Thornton, but before we do anything else, would you like to kiss your new bride? You would. Very good. Oh, fantastic. Well, congratulations. I'd like to be the first to give you Blake and Teagan Thornton.
If you didn't already know, I'm Brady, Blake's younger brother. And if you know Blake or anything about him, you probably have a decent idea of his fishing addiction. So first of all, I want to say thank you for teaching me to fish and for showing me a way to be broke the rest of my life. But also, I want you to know that you don't usually catch much, and the ones you do aren't very good. That being said, it looks like you got a keeper, so don't blow it. If y'all know Blake, you also probably know how hard he strives to get things right and to do things right. And I think that's a characteristic that is going to be very vital in y'all's relationship in the future. And I hope that you always use that and choose to lead your family in a way that is godly and upright, and constantly keeping your wife and your family on that path. Teagan, even though it's been not very long, and I haven't really gotten to know you too much, but it's been cool getting to know you so far as the girl that Blake's been crazy about the past couple of years. I'm even more eager to get to know my new sister. Y'all have demonstrated a Christ-like relationship, and so that I want to thank y'all. And I'm sure everybody else that has been around y'all can see that as well through y'all's dating years, and even more so in these next several years. I'm so excited for y'all's future. And I want to encourage each of you to always try to find the good in one another, even if you have to dig a little deeper some days. I love you both, and I wish you both the best of luck in your future together.
Okay, so unlike Brady, I'm not good at public speaking, but I can read, so I'm gonna do that. But for those who don't know, I'm Bailey. I'm Teagan's matron of honor and best friend. Okay. So while we haven't really been best friends for like forever, we haven't been best friends since diapers. It really does feel that way. Okay. I know one thing that most of us girls, growing up do is we dream a lot. We grow up and we dream about what we want to be. We want to think about who we want to be like, whether it's our parents or somebody else. But more importantly, we dream about who we're going to marry. We think about who our future husband will be, our Prince Charming and the father to our future little families. And oftentimes these dreams do coincide with the people that we're closest with. And I found that to be very true for me and Teagan. So Blake, I have spent countless nights staying up with our best friend, talking about the perfect wedding, our perfect God-fearing husband, and we all know that there's no such thing as a perfect husband, so good luck. but we've also talked a lot about the kind of marriages we hope to have and fight for. We've stayed up in tears because of broken spirits and unknown futures, but we've also spent countless nights driving down long roads, listening to the most random playlists, eating greasy cheese fries, and belly laughing at random thoughts and really crazy people. But her smiles got bigger, and her peace about her future grew every day that she got to know you more. I've seen God's plans play out for the both of you, and I'm so excited to stand by you as you step into this new stage of life. It has honestly been one of the greatest privileges I've had, being able to watch the progression of your relationship. From first meeting this guy in Teagan's class to getting to celebrate y'all's engagement together, it really has been a true blessing. I know that y'all's relationship has grown a lot and overcome a lot, and I've just been blessed to sit back and watch. And also, over the last week, I've gotten the privilege to gather just different words that your closest friends and family would use to describe you. This list includes words such as sweet, adorable, joyful, you're smitten, honest, forever, godly, pure, soulmates, genuine, you're a lifetime commitment, you're happy, you're in sync, you're crazy, fun, goofy, loving, and real. And along with those words, several people also described you both as Christ-centered and blessed. And I've loved hearing these people's opinions of you because I've gotten to see how y'all have impacted other people's lives, not just mine. But now I get the opportunity to share with you words that I think describe your relationship and how you've both impacted me. So first, y'all are best friends. And this makes me so happy. Y'all are truly the best of friends and can make any event one filled with laughter and joy. Whether it's game nights, date nights, nights filled with homework, or just sitting on the couch watching TV, you do it side by side. You are each other's greatest confidants. You can tell each other any secret, any heartache. It's just so beautiful to watch y'all be best friends. I know, along with me, you've been able to jam to very unique playlists with Blake. I don't know how many guys know most of Kesha's songs, but I know that Blake does. But you love each other and you forgive each other well. Blake, I am honored to share my best friend with you, and I love watching you take care of her better than I ever could. You are celebrators. You both celebrate each other really well. From birthdays or anniversaries or passing hard exams or even getting through a really hard day, you know how to encourage and lift one another up better than any other relationship that I've ever seen. So Blake, thank you, A, for spoiling Teagan, but B, for letting me see what it's like for a man to consistently pursue the woman he loves. And Teagan, thank you for showing me how to set my own desires aside and cherish the people I love selflessly. Your love for Blake and the way you cherish him is inspiring. You're prayer warriors. I've gotten to witness this and be completely encouraged to your commitment to pray for one another you ask each other how you can pray for one another week by week. I've gotten to see different prayer requests, things y'all are going through. And it's been amazing to see from a distance God's answers to those prayers. And not only do you pray for each other, but you pray for those around you together. I know from personal experience, y'all lifting me up in prayer. Y'all just really impacted my life in that way, and I'm really thankful for that. Okay. Y'all are overcomers. This past year especially has not been easy for the two of you. From deciding on what you want to study and do as a career, to standing by Blake's side through an appendicitis, but especially both of you fighting through almost a year of hand surgeries and therapy appointments, you never leave or give up or stop fighting. I've also, and more importantly, watched you stand by each other's sides through more serious emotional battles, and I've seen you overcome some of the hardest obstacles. What I love is how much more you're able to overcome together than separately. It's amazing to see how God's timing has worked out in your relationship. And lastly, you're a work in progress, and that's not a bad thing at all. Today, as you commit your lives together, I'm looking at two completely different people than the Teagan I met in high school and the Blake that I met almost 3 years ago. God is sanctifying you. He's shaping you to look more like him every day, and that will continue for the rest of your lives. So I'm excited to see you work together as works in progress to love others and further God's kingdom. I know your hearts, and I know that this marriage, as many of your friends and family have said, is blessed and from the Lord. So with that said, Blake and Teagan, congratulations. I love you both, and I am blessed to watch God work in your marriage.
Doing all almost everything but sitting still. Talking about her ballet shoes, her training wheels, and her kittens. And she thinks we're just fishing.
let's give it up for both families tonight.
Give me all, give me your attention, baby. I gotta tell you a little something about yourself. You're one of our flawless, ooh, you a sexy lady. But you walk around here like you wanna be someone else. Ooh, oh, I know that you don't know it, but you're fine, so fine.
Fine, so fine.
Ooh, oh, oh, girl, I'm gonna show you when you're mine.
Treasure, you are my treasure.